to meet the most successful X Factor contestant ever. Leona Lewis won the show in 2006 and has become a global phenomenon. She's sold nearly 7 million albums around the world and has had 2 number one singles. Her second album's about to be released, and so is her single called Happy. And I went to ask her all about it. Leona, lovely to meet you. Thank you very much for your time today.
Thank you.
I've been very excited about meeting you. And you're back with a new single and a new album. Is the album everything you wanted it to be? Is it the album you wanted to make?
Yeah, this is the album that it definitely just represents me through and through. I gotta find my place. I've had a long time to work on it, relatively long time. You can always have longer, but it definitely represents me, and I'm so happy with it.
Fantastic. And you worked with Clive Davis.
Mm.
He's responsible for Whitney Houston and Justin Timberlake. That must have been very exciting for you.
Yeah, I've been working with Clive Davis for a few years now, and it's always great to have someone like that on your team, really, because he's been behind some of the most amazing artists, I think, like Whitney and Alicia Keys, Santana as well. So it's great to have his backing and his support.
Did you ever expect to be as successful as you have been?
I always hope to do well, like everyone, but you know, the reaction to the first album was just, it just blew me away. But I don't care what they say.
I have heard that you've hired Michael Jackson's choreographer. Can we expect to see you busting some dance moves?
I haven't hired Michael Jackson's choreographer, sorry.
That's a lie.
That'd be amazing. But I'm doing a tour, so that's probably where that came from. So.
Okay. Can we expect a lot of dancing in the tour? What kind of tour is it going
Don't
to be?
Don't know. There's a bit of movement. I mean, I did dance when I was, you know, when I was young. My mum was a ballet teacher, so I grew up doing ballet and contemporary. So if there was any dance, it would be different from, you know, a bit of a street dance kind of thing.
Do you like to go out to the disco and pull some dance moves?
Yeah,
out?
I can throw a shape on the dance floor, definitely.
Yeah, you look that kind of girl to me. Snow Patrol before.
I did.
This time you've chosen an Oasis track to cover. Mm. Do you know if either of the Gallagher brothers have heard it yet?
I don't think so. The album's not out yet, so probably not, but I think it's an amazing song. Oasis is such a great band, and I guess maybe in a former life I was part of a male rock band or something, because I get an urge to cover these songs, but it's a great song.
And I've got to ask you about the X Factor. Have you been watching?
I have. I've watched it a bit, and it's so entertaining. I love, you know, watching it. I Skype plus it, so whenever I can, I sit down at home and watch it.
And who are your favourites?
I don't know, because it's hard to say, because I haven't really seen enough of them. I think now we'll see who kind of starts to peak and who kind of drops or levels out.
Do you think that shows like The X Factor are the only way to get into the industry these days?
No, far from it. You know, obviously it's I believe it's harder to get into the industry now than it was probably like 10 years ago or even 5 years ago. But that's not the only way you can get into it. My advice for artists is to just keep on striving through it, keep doing your gigs, you know, finding management, producers, people that can really help you, and just fine-tuning your craft, really, because I don't believe that's the only way you can get into music.
And would you ever consider being a judge on The X Factor?
I don't know. I don't know how good of a judge I'd be. I don't know. It's about, you know, turning people away and that kind of upsets me a bit. I think I'd cry a lot.
Oh. Do you still speak to Simon, though?
I do, yeah. He's very involved in the record, so, yeah, always speaking to him.
So something I must ask you about is you worked with the very lovely Justin Timberlake for your new album.
Yeah.
How did you find that?
It was great working with him. I met him at a show that we did together, and he was getting into producing, and I think he'd just recently done a Ciara track, and just producing for a few people, and I was like, yeah, let's work together, and we got in the studio, and he produced a song for me called Don't Let Me Down. I think he's very much like me. That's probably why we got along well in the studio, so that was a really cool experience.
Which is similar personalities.
Yeah, we're very focused, quite laid back, and yeah, we just got along.
And who would have thought a few years ago you'd be working with such
I know, especially Justin Timberlake. Like, I just fell in love with him. And I still am, of course. He's amazing. So it was really cool to do that.
So definitely some of your dreams have come true.
Yeah, definitely.
It's been really lovely
Thank
meeting you.
Thank you. Lovely to meet you.
And I wish you all the best with the new album and the new tour. It's going to be great.
Thank you.
You know what's great about that? When you consider how great she is coming out of X Factor, and Jedward could win it.
Just not right.
How great would that be?
She was such a talent, though, wasn't she? She's such a find, and she doesn't seem like she's changed at all.
No, very, very down to earth girl, and wish her all the best for the album. She was very nice.